Arguably the most important commodity in the world, oil, has encountered a huge price shock, big enough to make the markets panic like they haven't in a very long time. Governments and media have tried to calm the situation down. However, as in all situations, we must ask the question, who stands to gain from these events? Let's discuss that today. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're going to talk about what has happened in Saudi Arabia. It's important to see this particular commodity on a daily basis to follow what is happening. It is absolutely instrumental in the global economy. If the price goes higher, everything else will be affected because transport will bring those prices higher. If you encounter these shocks, as we had seen, let's say during the 70s, you have major events that take place as a result. Also, we could find that if there is a disruption in the supply, that can send the price higher. There are geopolitical events that could affect this as well. So many different factors here could affect the price, which then has an impact directly on the economies around the world. Now, of course, you don't want this particular commodity or any other to come from one individual source, because when we have that, there's a supply disruption and suddenly it has such a major impact. When everything's running smoothly, hey, nothing to worry about. Everything is just fine. But it's great when you have this coming from all different sources all around the world and you don't have to worry. I don't think a lot of people understand that. Why would you import from here or there or do this or that? And this is one instance in which it makes a lot of sense. Now, you have a country like Saudi Arabia that is exporting oil to many places around the world. It is one of the major exporters. And then we see this and how much of an effect it has, despite the fact that we have seen others exporting to such a great degree, number one being the United States. So I want to bring up two issues today, but first I'm going to get to the basic knowledge. I'm sure you've been seeing it in the news. I just wanted to cover this for those who haven't seen it, give you the price, give you the action, and then get into the deeper details. I'll bring it to you as quick as I can. Dow set to lose more than 150 points on fear spiking oil will slow the global economy. At the bottom of this page, this is the largest supply shock ever. The world is dependent on strategic reserves right now, and we can see that we're being told these reserves are ready to come online. However, Saudi and other countries have said there isn't a reason to worry at this point because the world is filled with oil from all different corners, so no need to be concerned. And initially, the price for Brent crude spiked 19.5%. Now that has changed since the recording of this video, and it had risen approximately 11%, 10.61 to be exact. If you look at the chart on the right hand side, you see that spike that was there. It came down from its peak, but it is still elevated considerably. If you look at WTI crude, that is up nearly 10%. And there are others here that may interest you if you want to look here in this list. Shanghai oil futures also spiked higher, and this just shows you that it is having an impact on all markets. There's no doubt about that. Crude prices surged more than 19% after this oil facility in Saudi was attacked, and this apparently removed about 5% of global supplies. State energy producer Saudi Aramco lost about 5.7 million barrels per day of output on Saturday. And there's something very interesting about this situation that I want to talk more about in a moment. For the oil market, and to me this is huge, it's the single worst sudden disruption ever. That surprised me. I didn't realize how much of an impact this has had already, even though they have suggested that they have it under control. The global economy can ill afford higher prices at a time of economic slowdown. We already have the entire shipping industry from top to bottom that is suffering right now. Imagine you add on a higher oil price, which of course means higher gasoline prices and so on. This isn't good, particularly at this time. If it happened, let's say back in 2013, 2012, maybe it wouldn't be such an issue, but today it is definitely going to impact the economy if this persists. Also, we need to factor in what's going on between Saudi and certain other countries and how this could unfold into something much, much worse. They're already talking about it. There's already some saber saber-rattling happening. We'll see what the results are. The closure will impact nearly 5 million barrels of crude processing per day, affecting 5% of the world's daily oil production. And while Aramco is confident that it can recover quickly, if it can't, however, the world could face a production shortage of as much as 150 million barrels per month, an outcome which could send oil prices into the triple digits. Now, I'm not necessarily saying that that's the case, but this is what we are being told. And of course, the impact would be very, very intense. Third place, Saudi Arabia was the world's third biggest producer of oil in August. Here you can see the US, Russia, Saudi Arabia in third. The IEA says the oil market's well supplied after what happened in Saudi. The International Energy Watchdog said that the global oil markets are, for now, well supplied with ample commercial stocks. Of course, they want to keep the prices elevated, whether that's OPEC, whether that's some of the other producers. But even in this case here, the IEA doesn't work for the people. Most of these supranational organizations are all working in concert together. In this case here, they are trying to calm everyone down. And you could see that because this information is coming from every corner of the world right now. I'm not necessarily suggesting that prices are going to escalate dramatically unless we see tensions heating up. The geopolitical problems that have been brewing for a while could easily spark something very bad in the near future. This right here is out of Bloomberg, and it's a few economists and others who are basically just making their predictions for the prices of oil, how they'd be affected by what we're seeing here. Some say that it's going to increase by $10 a barrel. Brent could go to $80, WTI to $75. I'm not really sure about all of this, okay? These predictions tend to never work out this way. But I do think that if we see an escalation there in the rhetoric, or maybe even some limited events that do occur, then the price of oil is going to be affected by that. Of course, the economy will suffer as a result. This is interesting here. Saudi Aramco incident GIF via NASA shows how flaring continues across various oil and gas facilities in Saudi to relieve pressure within integral pipelines as the main oil processing stabilization complex goes offline. And if you were to hit play on here, you can basically just see these black lines and how they move. I'm not sure if you could see that on your screen, but it just gives you an idea of how this looks from a top-down view. And remember how just a moment ago I was telling you how they were saying everything's under control, but it doesn't look like that's the case. Well, check this out. It is not under control, as the BBC claims. Still burning. Fresh pics via Snap. Now, this was earlier, of course, but it just shows you how the media seems to be reporting one thing, and then we get some other information that comes out that suggests something else is going on. We'll see what happens in the coming hours, the coming days. Of course, I will be reporting to you. Remember at the beginning of this video, I asked the question, who stands to gain from these events? Saudi Aramco is preparing for what could turn out to be the world's largest IPO, initial public offering. The state-run oil company is currently aiming to list as much as 5% of its shares sometime between 2020 and 2021. This has been delayed consistently, and part of the reason, many believe, is because the price of oil has been much lower than where they would want it to be. Now, these events here could spark the price to go higher, which would give them more of a benefit if they were going to put out their IPO. Now, I don't know what's going on in the inside. I'm unable to speculate, but isn't it quite interesting that this is happening right now? If the tensions heat up, this price would persist and potentially go higher from this point on, making this IPO more and more valuable, at least potentially more and more valuable. There have been so many events in history that we have seen that are conjured up by governments. Now, I don't know the information. Perhaps we'll find out some more in the near future. But all I'm saying here is that there's a certain group that stands to gain and another group that will certainly lose out. And the average person is going to lose out from higher oil prices. because of the tensions, because of the concerns that people are having now, you can see that this is having an impact on gold and silver. Both of these have risen, gold now over 1500 again. We'll see if things heat up more, and of course the impact on precious metals. This is an article here that if you want to know more, if you want some really good charts, quite a few charts in fact, and a lot of detail in this article out of Our Finite World, there's a line right here that says, our problem is not just that oil prices are too low for practically every type of energy producer and in many parts of the globe. And I'm not sure if you've ever seen those charts before, but it compares the price of crude oil to water and Coca-Cola and other things that we use every day, and the price seems extremely low. You don't realize that because you're putting it in your gas tank and it's not being consumed at the dinner table. It just gives you a different perspective on it. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, hit the thumbs up button. When you hit the like button, you're supporting this channel. If you want to build a business, if you want to make money passively, I have a free e-course, step-by-step, teaching you how to sell on Amazon. I just added a whole series of videos, and I'm going to add more. Stay tuned for that. TheAmazonGPS.com. If you want the financial education you were not taught in school, these two books have everything you need. The foundation, the history, the asset classes, making money. There's so much more in both of these. Check them out at the link in the description. If you want the audiobook, that's available at themoneygps.com. Hold on, hang on a second. There are over 8,500 stores that are closing in the United States already this year, 2019. I break it down for you in this video. Click on it and I will see you there.